You don't have to be much of a science enthusiast to have heard that you can't go faster than light. Well, I'm going to tell you at least one way that two real, honest-to-God objects that exist in our universe can move away from one another faster than the speed of light. Now, don't get super excited. I'm talking about ways this can happen without breaking the laws of physics. To be ultra clear, I'm not talking about something that will lead to this. Or this.
Engage.
Or this.
We're gonna have to go right to ludicrous speed. Ludicrous speed? Sir, we've never gone that fast before.
I mean, I totally want to know how to go ludicrous speed, but unfortunately, and I hate to have to tell you, these are all fiction. So if it's possible to go faster than light, what exactly do I mean by the speed of light? I mean the speed of light in a vacuum in a location where space-time is not bent or changing. Under those conditions, the speed of light is about 186,000 miles per second, or for the metric crowd, precisely 299,792.458 kilometers per second, or fast enough to circle the globe 7.5 times in a single second. Light is like really, really fast. When physicists use the symbol C to denote the speed of light, it's this speed that they're talking about. So how can you go faster than light? I can think of three examples, although they all aren't quite what you probably think. The first is cheating. When light enters a transparent medium like water or glass or something, it slows down. In glass, light travels at about 2/3 the speed it does in a vacuum. In water, it's about 3/4. You can see the effect of this change in velocity by simply sticking a pencil in a glass of water. The pencil doesn't really bend, but it appears to because of this effect. While light slows down in the transparent medium, other particles do not. That means that if you shoot an electrically charged particle, like an electron or a muon, traveling at near the speed of light at that same medium, the charged particle travels faster than light in the medium. Cool, huh? When this happens, the charged particle emits blue light, like you can see here. This light is called Cherenkov light, after its discoverer, Pavel Cherenkov. Explaining just how Cherenkov light is formed is, well, tricky, and maybe I'll make a video about that. But the blue light that you see here proves that it's possible for objects to move faster than light in a transparent medium. In this example, the light is formed when radioactive material emitting highly energetic particles is immersed in water. It's all way cool. So that's maybe a cheat. Particles move faster than light, but it's not because particles got faster, but because light got slower. Are there any other examples? Well, there is another instance of information traveling faster than light, which I'll mention only briefly, and this involves a topic called quantum entanglement. Quantum entanglement is a category of quantum mechanics, which is known for its bizarre predictions, cats both alive and dead and all that. It's not possible to explain it in detail here. That would actually require not just one video, but an entire series. But here, I can give the highlights. In quantum mechanics, probability rules. Anything that is possible can happen, governed by the probabilities of that particular situation. As an example, a subatomic particle can have a spin of plus or minus. You can't know which of those spins it has until you actually measure it. It's important to understand that this isn't a simple case of ignorance. It's not that the spin is plus or minus and you just don't know. It's both plus and minus, and it becomes plus or minus when you measure it. Now suppose you take two particles and set them up so that they have opposite spins. If one is plus, the other is minus, and vice versa. When physicists do this, they say that we've entangled the two particles. You can't know in advance which particle is plus and which is minus. You then separate the two particles by a large distance and look at one of them. Say you find that it's a plus spin. If you look at the other particle, you'll find it's a minus spin every single time. And this will be true even if you look at the second particle so quickly that you see it before a signal arrives from the first particle traveling at the speed of light. Einstein called this a spooky action at a distance, and it says that the information in quantum mechanics can travel faster than light. Nobody understands this, but it's well established and it's just a true effect. So that's a case of something traveling faster than light, but you can't use it to send a message, and it's still not the same as an object moving faster than light like the Starship Enterprise or the Millennium Falcon. So let's talk about a third situation where things actually can travel faster than light, and that's the expansion of the universe. Now I should be cautious. When you hear people saying, the universe expands faster than light, it's obviously a statement that requires some care. Because your first question should be, what does that mean? Well, obviously, the universe can't mean our planet, our solar system, or even our galaxy. After all, none of them are expanding much, if at all, and certainly not at the speed of light. In 1929, American astronomer Edwin Hubble combined measurements taken by several people and found that distant galaxies are moving away from Earth, and the further away they are, the faster they're moving. This is now understood to be evidence that the universe is expanding. Using modern numbers, a galaxy a megaparsec away is moving away from us at 70 kilometers per second. A megaparsec is a million parsecs, which is 3.26 million light years, by the way, but astronomers use megaparsecs, so I will too. If a galaxy a megaparsec away is moving away at 70 kilometers per second, a galaxy 2 megaparsecs away is moving away at 140 kilometers per second. 3 megaparsecs means 210 kilometers per second, and so on. So we know that the speed of light is 300,000 kilometers per second. So we can figure out how far away we have to go to have a galaxy moving away from us at the speed of light. That turns out to be 4,296 megaparsecs, or just shy of 14 billion light years. This means that the surface of a sphere centered on the Earth and with a radius of about 14 billion light years is moving away from us at the speed of light. It also means that bigger spheres are moving away from us at faster than light. A sphere with a radius 28 billion light years across is expanding at twice the speed of light. So what does this mean? Does it mean that there are galaxies moving away from us at speeds faster than light? Yeah. Yeah, it does. Of course, it also means that we can never see them. If objects move away from us faster than light, then that means that light emitted by them can never get to our eyes. So we can never see light emitted by anything currently further away than 14 billion light years. The true number is a little different because of details of how the expansion speed has changed over time. To get the number right means we have to take a more nuanced approach than I'm doing here, but those details really don't change the big message. It's also incredibly important to be super careful about how we envision it. The reason is that it's not precisely accurate to say that these galaxies are moving away from us faster than light. Yes, the distance between us is increasing, but it's because space is expanding, not because the galaxy is moving away in space. It's kind of like putting a rubber duck in a river. The duck isn't moving as far as the water is concerned. It's the water that's carrying the duck away. Or like drawing dots on a balloon that's inflating. The dots don't move on the surface of the balloon, but the distance between them is increasing because the balloon is stretching. So it's entirely fair to say that there exist galaxies that move away from us faster than light, but only in the sense that the expansion of space makes it happen. Those galaxies are stationary, or at least nearly stationary, with respect to their own space. They're not moving through space. I've described three examples of the phenomenon, but none of them are something that those of us who hope to explore the cosmos would like to see. According to our best understanding of the laws of physics, light obeys the ultimate speed limit. Now, our understanding of the rules that govern the universe are constantly improving, and it's okay to hope that we'll discover some new principle that makes it possible to go faster than light. Although unlikely, it may be that we will eventually find some new phenomena that changes our prospects for exploring the galaxy. And then, and only then, we will finally have figured out a way to go
ludicrous speed!
People say that it's impossible to go faster than light, and as a practical matter, it's probably true. But we've learned in this video about a few ways in which we can at least kind of break that rule. So now you have some tidbits to use at your next cocktail party. You're welcome. If you like what you've seen, remember to be sure to like, share, and comment. We want to know what you think. And, as always, remember, physics is everything.